remember when it was easy to wipe my ass. One time I sat on my friend's toilet and broke her toilet, and I have a picture of that. My biggest thing is I want to get healthy. You know, I want to, I'm an older woman, and I want to make sure that my time here is well spent. And it's just the simple things that I once enjoyed doing that I no longer enjoy doing it because it hurts to move. It hurts to walk. I'm short-winded. I'm out of breath when I come up my stairs. And I remember the almost for a year, I couldn't even walk up my stairs without almost having to crawl up the stairs. That's just how how bad the pain was from my waist down, and my knee in particular, where I couldn't put any weight on one side of my knee. And that was the reason why I just had to really do this. You know, I have some stories. I do plan on sharing my airplane experiences and just the struggle with just getting on an airplane. And then the one time I sat on, it was the most embarrassing moment for me, but the one time I sat on my friend's toilet, I went to her bathroom and sat on the toilet and broke her toilet. And I have a picture of that. I'll share that story. I don't know if you guys want to hear those stories. Just some of the most embarrassing moments and some of the things that I struggled with this weight gain. And it's limiting some of the things that I'm able to do. Like simple stuff, like wipe my ass, you know. I don't remember when it was easy to wipe my ass, but I do know that it haven't always been this way. It hasn't always been this way. It hasn't always been to where I have to actually get up off of the toilet, stand up, turn around and face the toilet, put one leg on the toilet seat, squat down just to wipe between my butt. It is the most... I'm about to cry because it's an awful experience. It's a really bad experience. And sometimes when you use a public restroom and you're confined to a small space and you don't have that luxury of taking your pants off and throwing one leg up because your pants are tight. So it's like, okay, I gotta strip my pants. And I've had to do that too in order to wipe my butt when I go in public. And so my thing was, I don't wanna have to do the number two in public, because if I do the number two in public, I'm not gonna be able to wipe my ass. And having to drive home with shit in between your butt cracks because you couldn't wipe it. It has been an awful experience, and I don't know. I think without me actually talking about it, I just learned how to deal with it. But actually talking about it, I've never cried about not being able to wipe my ass. But I never cried about that shit. It never hit me like this. But I think talking about it, this is why people gotta see psychiatrists. Just having those moments where I can remember, you know how you have girls and y'all just, you know, one person's in the bathroom or whatever, having those moments where you don't want anybody to see you in the bathroom, or your friends are out in the living room and you're sitting on the toilet, but when it's time to, you know, wipe your ass, you gotta close the door because you know that your wiping ass is a whole orchestra of shit that has to go on, you know? So it's not a simple wipe and wash your hands and go. It's, you know, you gotta take off some layers to unrestrict, is that a word? I don't even know. To kind of, to loose yourself of being in bondage so that you could move. So it's just those things, you know, like even to the point where, you know, having to get, you know, I don't remember. I think we take those things for granted when we can do it. So I do, I don't remember it always being an issue, but I do notice it now that it is an issue. You know, like simple stuff like being able to wipe or wash between my butt cheeks. Now I have to use the extended long washcloths and use that as a, like a, it's just, it's, because I don't want to smell. That's the other thing. You think if you see, oh, I've been conditioned to think from a young age, and maybe because I've experienced it, most big people have a body odor. So when I started gaining the weight, it was, oh, make sure I have perfume, or I don't want to sweat because I don't want anybody to smell. And then sometimes you have those days when you get home and you take off all your clothes where you sweat and you be like, oof, I'm so glad nobody smelled that, because that is funky. You know, it's just having those moments, and I'm gonna, you know, where I'm gonna stop recording because my face is all red and stuff now. But yeah, it's just, so I'll share some of those experiences, some of those stories, some of those things that just really like was like, this is it. You gotta change. You gotta change something.